Imagine managing mood swings and psychosis, not just with medication, but with food. That's what I'm talking about today. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. You might already be familiar with keto for weight loss, or maybe even for its use in treating epilepsy in children. But now we're talking about using it to treat mood swings and psychosis. A 2024 study from psychiatry research showed promising results that a ketogenic diet reduced symptoms of bipolar disorder and schizophrenia and reversed metabolic syndrome. Let's unpack the science behind this. First off, although this was a small study, there have been other studies showing that the ketogenic diet has reduced symptoms of schizophrenia. But this is the first one that has pulled in bipolar disorder. Why are these two conditions being paired together? Bipolar disorder and schizophrenia, although very distinct conditions, share some striking similarities when you look at the underlying biology. Both of these conditions are thought to involve disruptions in neurotransmitters like dopamine and glutamate. Brain scans of people with bipolar disorder and schizophrenia show structural brain changes in similar areas. And both conditions are associated with a high degree of brain inflammation and oxidative stress, which is how the ketones help. This is not to say that bipolar disorder and schizophrenia are the same thing. They are very distinct in how they affect you. Bipolar disorder is a mood disorder where you have episodes of depression and mania or hypomania. So you primarily have mood instability, and if your symptoms become really intense, you can become psychotic. But the psychosis is a measure of the intensity of your mood state. As your symptoms improve, psychosis is one of the first symptoms to resolve. With schizophrenia, on the other hand, the primary issue is psychosis, which includes disordered thinking. I won't go into detail in this video about what I mean by that because I don't want to go too far down a rabbit hole. You can check out my playlist on schizophrenia and bipolar disorder to better understand the nuances of how the two conditions look. I'll have those playlists listed in the description of this video. So what exactly is the ketogenic diet? The ketogenic diet is very low in carbohydrates and high in fats. And eating this way induces a state of ketosis where the body primarily burns fat for energy instead of carbohydrates. Normally, your brain and body rely primarily on glucose that comes from the breakdown of carbs. But with the keto diet, your liver takes fat from the areas where it's stored and makes ketones. And this is what your brain and body use for energy. The common ketones are acetone and beta-hydroxybutyrate. Even if you don't restrict your carbs, your liver makes these ketones under certain conditions, like an overnight fast or with sustained high-intensity exercise. So we all make ketones, but with a ketogenic diet, you restrict your carbs so much that you have high levels of ketones in your system. Sometimes you can detect a ketotic state because high levels of acetone will leave a fruity smell on your breath. Why do the ketones help? Ketones are neuroprotective because they reduce oxidative stress in the nerve cells and reduce brain inflammation. Oxidative stress is like rust in your brain. Our bodies naturally produce small amounts of free radicals that can damage cells, and ketones reduce this process. Ketones also boost the function of a structure inside the cells called mitochondria. Mitochondria are super important, and research has found that people with schizophrenia and bipolar disorder have dysfunctional mitochondria. And lastly, ketones are thought to help restore normal dopamine and glutamine function. Another thing the study showed was that the ketogenic diet reversed metabolic syndrome. Metabolic syndrome is a group of conditions that occur together, increasing your risk of heart disease, stroke, and type 2 diabetes. These conditions include high blood pressure, high blood sugar, excess body fat, especially around the waist, and abnormal cholesterol and triglyceride levels. Metabolic syndrome can be reversed with lifestyle modifications, but they usually take a while. In this 4-month study, not only did people lose weight, but all signs of metabolic syndrome were gone. Now, with all of this said, the ketogenic diet is not a magic bullet, and it definitely has some risk associated with it. Here are some to keep in mind. First, there's the keto flu. This is an initial adjustment phase that you can suffer through as your body switches to burning fat. With it, you can experience a bunch of physical symptoms like headaches, fatigue, dizziness, brain fog, and irritability. These symptoms are temporary and they usually pass within a few days to a couple of weeks. Another issue is nutrient deficiencies. The keto diet restricts certain food groups, which means you have to make sure that you're getting enough vitamins, minerals, and fiber. A good multivitamin can fill in those gaps, and prioritizing non-starchy vegetables also can help. The higher protein load and changes in your body's acidity balance can increase the risk of kidney stones. And the high fat content of the diet could be a concern for anyone with existing liver problems. And here's another thing. Because of the low fiber content, you may get constipated. And then the restrictive nature of this diet can trigger unhealthy eating patterns for those who are predisposed to disordered eating. If you are considering trying a ketogenic diet, you really should consult a dietitian before proceeding. A dietitian can customize your eating plan for you, taking into account any medical issues you have, like diabetes or high cholesterol. You still may benefit from a modified ketogenic diet that allows for more vegetables or other foods that keep you from becoming nutrient deficient. If you have other medical conditions, you should also consult with your doctor in case you're taking a medication that is affected by a high-fat diet. A high-fat diet can affect the absorption and metabolism of various medications, like some antibiotics, some oral contraceptives, and some cardiovascular medications. For example, beta blockers like propranolol can be used to treat blood pressure, migraines, heart arrhythmias, and panic attacks, and their absorption can be increased with high-fat meals. So if you're regularly eating high-fat meals, your body may be absorbing more of the medication. More absorption can mean better results, or it can mean you start having side effects. And if this happens, you may need your dose adjusted. This study is a good starting point and a glimmer of hope that there are lifestyle interventions that we can use to manage these conditions. And I'm eager for larger studies that can give us more answers. For more information on bipolar disorder and schizophrenia, take a look at these other videos. Thanks for watching today. See you next time.